Let us continue carbonyl compounds. In the carbonyl compounds, we will continue aldol condensation. Now we will take carbonyl compound CH3CO, CH2 four times, CHO. Aldol condensation in the sense alpha hydrogen should be there. At least one alpha hydrogen should be there. Sir, it is aldehyde group. This carbon is directly attached to this aldehyde group. Therefore, this carbon is alpha carbon. It is alpha hydrogen. It is carbonyl group. This is having alpha carbon, alpha hydrogen. Alpha carbon, alpha hydrogen. It's there. Okay, alpha hydrogen is there. Next, we have to take a dilute alkali. We have to take dilute alkali OH minus. We are taking, sir. Next, in this first step, what in the sense OH minus is abstracting proton. This base, this alkali base is abstracting proton. Okay, which proton it will abstract? One possibility here. So three possibilities are there for abstracting proton. One here we said. Because these three are alpha hydrogens. So which proton it can abstract in the sense one which is having highest acidic nature. Which proton is having highest acidic nature that we want to see it, sir. Now if you see, this proton is attached to keto. Okay, so this proton is attached to C double bond O. This carbon also attached to C double bond O. So this carbon and this carbon more or less same. But this carbon, if you see, one side carbonyl group here, one side electron withdrawing group carbonyl group, another side electron withdrawing group carbonyl group. Therefore, we can say that this second carbon is having more. This hydrogen is having more acidic. Therefore, this OH minus is abstracting this proton. We can say, if OH minus is abstracting this proton, then this carbon will get a carbanion. This carbon will become C minus, like that we can say. Okay. So that which hydrogen is abstracted by base in the sense? Mostly this. Okay. Therefore, this base is abstracting this proton. Then this bond is shifting as carbanion. Okay. So we can say CH3, C double bond O, CH minus carbanion. Then CH2, 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 CHO. Like that we can say. Next step, this carbanion is attacking this carbonyl carbon. Then this bond is shifting here. Okay. So we will get, this is how many membered ring we will see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 membered ring we are getting. We are getting 5 membered ring. Here this O minus will give. O minus we have given. Then it is first carbon, second carbon, third carbon, fourth carbon, fifth carbon. Fifth carbon is having COCH3. First carbon, second carbon, third carbon, fourth carbon, fifth carbon. Fifth carbon is having COCH3. Fifth carbon is having COCH3. Okay. Then next, this O minus takes H plus from water and becomes OH. We can say. Now, here COCH3. Okay. Next. From this, if it is warmed, water molecule will be eliminated from here. What are the possibilities in the sense? On elimination of water, pi bond can be created in this place. Otherwise, in this place. Okay, so two possibilities are there. Therefore, CH3, CO. So pi bond is creating here. It is one possibility. Another possibility, pi bond is creating in this place. Okay, like this. So out of these two, which is more stable in the sense this pi bond is in conjugation with this pi bond. this pi bond is in conjugation with this pi bond. Therefore, it is having higher stability. Therefore, we can say it is major product. Okay. Here, this is aldol condensation, but takes within the molecule. Therefore, it is called a intramolecular aldol condensation. This is called intramolecular aldol condensation. Otherwise, aldol cyclization, we can say. Aldol cyclization. It is intramolecular aldol condensation, or otherwise aldol cyclization, we can say. Okay. Next equation we'll take. Here, CH3, CO, CH2, CH2, CO, CH3. Like this we'll take. This aldol condensation we'll see. So first, abstracting proton. Where and all possibility is there? That we'll see. One is this carbon, it is alpha carbon. Next, this carbon, alpha carbon. This carbon, alpha carbon. This carbon, alpha carbon. Now, A and D are equivalent. B and C also equivalent. Therefore, now we will take either A, otherwise B. Because this one and this one equivalent, we said. This one and this one equivalent. Similarly, these two also equivalent. Therefore, you take these two. In these two, which one shall we take? That you consider. Which is having more acidic nature, that you see. Now, this B hydrogen is having more acidic nature than A hydrogen. B hydrogen is more acidic than A hydrogen, we can say. Why? Because this CH2 is flanked by two electron withdrawing groups. This CH2 is in between two electron withdrawing groups, but A is with only one electron withdrawing group. Therefore, let us consider A, otherwise B we have to see. So B is having more acidic when compared to A. So, therefore, B is having more acidic. So we will consider B. So why we have considered B in the sense, it is more acidic. Therefore, only we have considered B. So OH minus, this OH minus is subtracting this proton. OH minus is subtracting proton. Therefore, this bond is migrating here. This becomes carbon ion. So CH3, CO, CH2, CH, this carbon becomes carbon ion, we said. CO, CH3. Next, what is the next step we'll see? This carbon ion can attack this CO. Therefore, this pi bond is migrating. So what you will get? This first carbon, it is second carbon, it is third carbon. We are getting three-membered ring. This O becomes O minus. This carbon is having O minus and CH3. That CH3 will write. It is first carbon, it is second carbon. Third carbon is having COCH3. 1, 2, 3. Third carbon is having COCH3. Okay. Here, we got three-membered ring. Three-membered ring in the sense. Here, what is the CC angle? This angle, CCC. This angle, if you see, 60 degree. 60 degree in the sense, it is having very large deviation from normal bond angle, 109 degree, 28 minutes. Normal tetrahedral bond angle is 109 degree, 28 minutes. From that, it is having large deviation. Therefore, your angle strain will be highest. Since angle strain is highest, three-membered ring is having very less stability. Three-membered ring is having very less stability. Therefore, we'll go for another possibility here. We'll go for next possibility. Okay, sir. Now, next possibility we'll see. Now, we will take OH minus. Here, actually, we are saying this CH2 carbon is having more acidic, we said. Therefore, only we proceeded. This CH2 carbon, this CH2 hydrogen is having more acidic, therefore we proceeded like this. But what is the drawback in the sense? It is resulting what in the sense? Three-membered ring. Therefore, we will see alternative. Okay. So what is the alternative in the sense? This OH minus is abstracting this proton and becoming water. Therefore, we are getting carbon ion. So what is the carbon ion we are getting in the sense? Here, so and so carbon ion we are getting. Here, so-and-so carbon ion we are getting. Okay, we got so-and-so carbon ion. Next, this carbanion is attacking this C double bond O. So this bond is migrating. So we are getting what membered ring? We'll see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 membered ring we are getting. We are getting a 5 membered ring, we can see. Okay. This double bond O becomes O minus. This first carbon, second, this first carbon is having O minus and CH3. O minus and CH3. Second carbon, third carbon, fourth carbon is having double bond O. 1, 2, 3, 4. Fourth carbon is having double bond O. Sir, like this we are getting. Next we'll see. This O minus we will make it as OH. This O minus abstracting proton from water. Therefore it is becoming OH. Therefore, here what is there means a double bond O is there. Next, this on warming, what is eliminating means, from here what is eliminating means water molecule is eliminating. From here water molecule is eliminating. If water molecule is eliminating, pi bond can be produced here, otherwise here. Two possibilities. If pi bond is created here, that will be in conjugation with this double bond. Therefore, it is having more stability. Therefore, pi bond is creating at this place. So we can say, here double bond O, here pi bond we can say, here methyl group we can say. So this compound is a major product we can say. Here major is this one, okay. So actually which hydrogen is having more acidic means this hydrogen is having more acidic when compared to this. Even then this proton only is losing, this proton only is leaving with the basic and giving, this is as a major product. This is a major product here, not this one, because it is 3-membered ring. Therefore, it is not major product. This is the major product, we can say. Okay. Next, we will take CH3, CO, CH2 3 times, CH2 3 times, then CHO. Okay. So, CH3, CO, CH2 3 times, CHO. Like this, we are taking. Now, in this one, first, proton has to be removed. So base is attacking here. Base is attacking, proton has to be removed. Which proton means it is alpha hydrogen. It is also alpha hydrogen. It is also alpha hydrogen. Which proton shall we remove? Shall we remove A or B or C? Which proton shall we remove? That we want to see it. Okay. Which proton we want to remove? Sir. Which is having more acidic, that proton will remove it. This is having more acidic, so we can remove this. If we remove this one, what membered ring we will get? 1, 2, 3, 4. 4-membered ring we will get. Sir, if we remove this one, what membered ring we will get? We'll see. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4-membered ring we will get. If we remove this one, what membered ring we will get? We'll see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6-membered ring we are getting. So, out of 4-membered and 6-membered, which is more stable in the sense? 6-membered is more stable when compared to 4-membered. Because in 4-membered, the CCC angle is 88 degree. Bayer's strain will be there. 6-membered ring in the sense, Bayer's strain will be less. Therefore, a 6-membered ring we can take. 6-membered ring is better, we can say. Therefore, this carbon, from this we have to remove proton. Okay. So from where we have to remove proton, that we got an idea. That is in this CH3, we have to remove the proton. Okay. So in this CH3, we are removing proton, we said. In this CH3, we are removing proton. Okay. So now this base OH minus is abstracting proton here. Therefore, this is becoming carbanion. This carbon becomes carbanion, we can say. So this is CH2, this carbon becomes carbanion, we said, here CO, then CH2 3 times, then C double bond OH, okay, like this we said. Next, this carbanion is attacking this carbonyl carbon, this double bond, pi bond shifting to O, okay. So what membered ring we are getting, we'll see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6-membered ring we are getting. six membered ring we are getting. Now this is a double bond O, we'll write. Okay, this is a double bond O. This O minus we want to write. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 at fifth carbon O minus. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 at fifth carbon O minus we have written. This O minus we will write it as OH. This O minus we will write it as OH. Okay. Then we have to remove water molecule. This on warming, water molecule will be eliminated. Which water molecule in the sense? Here, if water molecule is eliminating, here pi bond will be created. Otherwise, pi bond will be created here. This pi bond is in conjugation with this double bond. This pi bond is in conjugation with this double bond. Therefore, that will have stability. Therefore, we will give pi bond here, not here. Okay. So, we can write O double bond. We will give pi bond where in the sense, here we can give pi bond. Okay. Pi bond we have given here. Now this is having higher stability, therefore this is major product we can say. So the intramolecular aldol condensation gives a so-and-so product we can say here. Okay, we'll take next reaction. Next reaction we'll take CH3, C double bond O, CH2 four times, CH2 four times, then CO, CH3. Okay, we have taken like this. Now this, if you see which carbon we have to make it as carbon ion in the sense, no doubt here only, there is no other chance. Here only we have to do, here we cannot do. Why? Because everything is equivalent, and also we are not getting three membered or four membered, we are not getting. So remove this carbon, you take this H plus, you remove it. That H plus, this H plus, you remove it. Make it as carbon ion here, and proceed. Okay. So this carbon, you are this carbon you are considering from here H plus you are removing. Therefore, what is a major product we will get in the sense? So and so. So and so major product we are getting. Okay. Next, we will go for another naming reaction called Cannizzaro reaction. Cannizzaro's reaction. Okay, Cannizzaro's reaction will take. Cannizzaro reaction in the sense, we have to take carbonyl compound. In the carbonyl compound, alpha hydrogen should not be there. Alpha hydrogen should not be there. Then concentrated alkali we have to take. We have to take what in the sense? Concentrated alkali. So we are taking carbonyl compound. We are taking carbonyl compound. In the carbonyl compound, alpha hydrogen is not present. And we have to take a concentrated alkali. We have to take concentrated alkali. We are taking. Okay, sir. No alpha hydrogen. Carbonyl compound not having alpha hydrogen. One example is what in the sense? Formaldehyde. Formaldehyde is one example. It is having carbonyl. It is having carbonyl group. What means aldehyde? It is not having any carbon. Therefore, no carbon is bonded with carbonyl carbon. Therefore, alpha hydrogen is not, alpha carbon is not there. Alpha carbon not there in the sense, no question of alpha hydrogen. Okay, so that this compound is not having alpha hydrogen, we can say. Sir, this formaldehyde we have taken, this is treated with a concentrated alkali. In the aldol condensation, dilute alkali. In the aldol condensation, dilute alkali. Now concentrated alkali we are taking, concentrated alkali. So what is the mechanism involved here that we'll see? Now this alkali OH minus, this OH minus will act as a nucleophile here. In the previous case acted as base, now nucleophile. Okay, this O is attacking this carbon, this bond is migrating. Therefore what we are getting, we'll see HCH. This OH will write, this O becomes, say, this double bond becomes single bond O minus. Single bond O minus we can say. Here oxygen 3 lone pairs we can give. Okay. Next, we'll take formaldehyde. Next formaldehyde we'll take. Okay. Now how shift takes place we'll see. This lone pair shift as pi bond. The sigma bond shift to here. Then it is shifting here. Then this pi bond shifting to this O. Okay. So what is happening means this hydrogen takes the bond and shift to air. Therefore, H minus transfer will say. H minus transfer. This hydrogen takes the bond and goes to air as H minus. This H minus making a bond with this carbon. So this is what we'll see. This is what in the sense HC double bond OH. This is what in the sense that is a CH3O minus. CH3O minus we can say. So it is formic acid, it is methoxide. It is what in the sense formic acid, it is methoxide we can say. From year to year what is transferring, that we will see. This bond is shifting here, this H plus going to this place. So this is becoming what in the sense HCOO minus. This is what in the sense CH3OH. CH3OH. This O minus taking H plus. Therefore it is becoming CH3OH. This OH becomes O minus. Okay, this is the product. So here one formaldehyde is converting into formate means oxidation. Another formaldehyde converting into alcohol means reduction. Therefore one formaldehyde undergoes oxidation to give formate anion. Another formaldehyde undergoes reduction to give methyl alcohol. Therefore it is called a disproportionation reaction. This reaction, this Cannizzaro reaction is also called a disproportionation reaction. Disproportionation means same substance will undergo reduction as well as oxidation. Okay. Next, compound will take continuation of this Cannizzaro reaction. Now we'll take benzaldehyde. We can write it as CHO we have written. Here carbon. Here carbon atoms. Here we can write pi bonds. This is a carbonyl group. It is the functional group. This carbon is directly attached to the functional group. This carbon is called alpha carbon. This alpha carbon is not having hydrogen. So no alpha hydrogen for benzaldehyde. Benzaldehyde is not having alpha hydrogen. Okay. Therefore, no alpha hydrogen in the sense with concentrated alkali, it goes for Cannizzaro reaction set. So how the Cannizzaro reaction will be there, we'll see. In the first step, what happens means OH minus is acting as a nucleophile. Carbonyl carbon is acting as electrophile. So this OH minus is attacking this carbon. This bond is migrating here. So we are getting this phenyl ring. This CO minus. This O minus is having three lone pairs. Here hydrogen, here OH. This oxygen is having two lone pairs. Next, we'll take benzaldehyde. Okay. Now what happens means this lone pair is becoming pi bond. This bond shifting to hydrogen. This is attacking this carbon. This pi bond shifting to this O. Okay. So we are getting what in the sense? This phenyl ring. This is becoming C double bond O OH. This is what in the sense? Phenyl ring CH2O minus. Then next step is what in the sense? H plus transfer. This bond is migrating. H plus goes to this place. Therefore, it is becoming what in the sense? This phenyl ring. Here COO minus. This O minus becomes OH group. Okay. So This benzaldehyde undergoes oxidation to give benzoate anion oxidation. This benzaldehyde undergoes reduction to give benzyl alcohol. Benzaldehyde undergoes oxidation to give benzoate anion. Therefore, same substance, that means benzaldehyde undergoes oxidation as well as a reduction. Therefore, we can call this is as a disproportionation reaction. This Cannizzaro reaction is called a disproportionation reaction, we can say. Next substance we'll take Me3CCHO. We'll take concentrated alkali. What we'll get, we'll see. This Me3, we will write CH3, CH3, CHO, we can write like this. CHO, we can write like this. Now, this carbon is directly attached to carbonyl carbon, therefore, it is called alpha carbon. This alpha carbon is not having hydrogen, therefore, no alpha hydrogen. No alpha hydrogen in the sense it will not go for aldol condensation, it will go for Cannizzaro reaction. Cannizzaro reaction means one aldehyde group undergoes oxidation. Therefore, oxidation in the sense CHO becomes COO minus. Another aldehyde undergoes reduction, that means CHO becomes reduction, CHO becomes what in the sense CH2OH. So one is undergoing oxidation to give carboxylate anion, another one is undergoing reduction to give primary alcohol. Therefore, this is called a, what in the sense, Cannizzaro reaction, disproportionation reaction, we can say. Next reaction we'll take. In the next reaction, what we'll take in the sense, benzaldehyde, continuation of Cannizzaro reaction. One is benzaldehyde, another one is formaldehyde. Now concentrated alkali we'll take. Okay, benzaldehyde we have taken, formaldehyde we have taken, we have mixed both, and concentrated alkali we have taken. What we will get here, that we will see. Here, first step is what? In benzaldehyde and formaldehyde, no alpha hydrogen we know. First step is OH minus nucleophile has to attack carbonyl carbon. Which carbonyl carbon? Formaldehyde or benzaldehyde? Which it will attack? Which carbon is having higher electrophilicity? That we have to see. So now we will take benzaldehyde. We are taking benzaldehyde. Then we are taking formaldehyde. Now OH minus will attack which carbon, which carbonyl carbon, that we want to see. Which carbonyl carbon is having higher electrophilicity, we have to see. Here what is happening means, in the benzaldehyde, resonance is possible. Resonance in the sense like this possibility is there. Because of this resonance, here like this only possible. This carbon is getting partial positive charge. This carbon also partial positive charge because this pi bond is migrating, but resonance is possible. Therefore, magnitude of positive charge is more here, magnitude of positive charge is less. Therefore, this carbon is having higher electrophilicity than this carbon. So OH minus is having higher tendency to attack formaldehyde. Okay. So in this case, OH minus is attacking formaldehyde, not benzaldehyde. Okay. So OH minus is attacking which one in the sense? OH minus is attacking formaldehyde, we can say. So like this attack. So what we are getting in the sense? Like this we are getting. Okay. This O minus oxygen is having how many lone pairs in the sense? 3 lone pairs is there. Then this is here. Then it is attacking what in the sense? Benzaldehyde. That is attacking benzaldehyde, we can say. Okay. So how that attack will be there? We'll see. This lone pair becomes pi bond. This bond pair is shifting. This H takes this bond and becomes H minus. H minus is attacking this carbon. This pi bond shift to this place. Therefore, this becomes what in the sense? Formic acid. And this becomes what in the sense? It is a CH2O minus. Okay. This basic nature is more. It is base. It is acid. Therefore, acid base neutralization takes place. So this becomes formate anion. This becomes benzyl alcohol. This becomes benzyl alcohol. Okay. Therefore, in this case, if you mix benzaldehyde and formaldehyde, what happens means formaldehyde undergoes oxidation to give formate anion. Benzaldehyde undergoes a reduction to give benzyl alcohol. This is called a redox reaction, we can say. We cannot say disproportionation. Okay. Because same substance is not undergoing oxidation as well as reduction. Therefore, this reaction is called a crossed Cannizzaro reaction. This is called a crossed Cannizzaro reaction. Why it is called crossed Cannizzaro reaction in the sense one aldehyde undergoes oxidation, another aldehyde undergoes reduction. Therefore, only it is called a crossed Cannizzaro reaction, we can say. In the Cannizzaro reaction, we will take another reaction. Now we'll take a phenyl ring. Here CO group. Here CHO group. Okay. Like this is there. Here, keto group is there and aldehyde group is there. Therefore, it is ketoaldehyde. In this compound, in this molecule, keto group is there and aldehyde group is there. Therefore, we can say it is ketoaldehyde. Here, alpha hydrogen is not present. Okay. Now, OH minus is attacking now. OH minus will attack which carbonyl carbon? Which carbonyl carbon? CO or CHO? Which carbonyl carbon it will attack? Sir. Now, here pi bond is there. In this carbonyl group, pi bond is shifting. Therefore, partial positive charge. Here also pi bond is shifting. Therefore, partial positive charge. Sir, where positive charge magnitude is more, we have to see. Here, what happens means this carbon is undergoing resonance with the phenyl ring. Because of resonance, what happens means here magnitude of positive charge decreases, whereas here magnitude of positive charge will be same. Therefore, here magnitude is more when compared to this. Therefore, it is having higher electrophilic nature. Therefore, this OH minus is attacking this carbon. Okay, OH minus is attacking this carbon, we can say. OH minus is attacking aldehyde carbon, not ketonic carbon. Okay, aldehyde is attacking OH minus is attacking aldehyde carbon, we can say. So here O minus. Okay, next step we'll see. Next step, what happens? That we'll see. This lone pair becomes pi bond. This bond shift to H minus. This H minus attack this carbon. This bond shift to O. Okay. So that means H minus transfer. H minus transfer. Okay. H minus transfer, we can say. H minus transfer. Hydride shift. Hydride shift, we can say. Okay. So here H is coming. This double bond O becomes O minus. This is what in the sense C double bond O OH. We got like this. Okay. Next step, what is that means? This is base, it is acid. Therefore, acid base neutralization. This bond is shifting. This H plus is attacking here. H plus is attacking. Therefore, we are getting what product in the sense? Here ring, here OH, H. This is C double one O, O minus. This what in the sense O minus we can say. So and so we are getting. In this case, this aldehyde group undergoes oxidation to give carboxylate anion. This ketone undergoes a reduction to give alcohol. So within the molecule, one group goes for reduction, one group goes for oxidation. Therefore, we can call this is as a intramolecular Cannizzaro reaction. We can call this is as a intramolecular Cannizzaro reaction. Sir, intramolecular Cannizzaro reaction, we said here. Okay. Next reaction, we'll see. Intramolecular Cannizzaro reaction continuation. Here CHO, here CHO. So this compound contains two aldehyde groups. Therefore, we can say this is as a dialdehyde. This compound contains two aldehyde groups. Therefore, we can call this is as a dialdehyde, we can say dialdehyde. Sir, how the reaction is taking place here, we'll see. So first step is OH minus attack. OH minus attack will be which place? Which aldehyde OH minus will attack? OH minus will attack which aldehyde? Here two aldehydes given. Which aldehyde it will attack? It can attack any one aldehyde because both aldehyde are equivalent. Therefore, it can attack any one aldehyde. That's all. Sir, it can attack any one aldehyde group, we said. So we are getting what in the sense? Here CHO, here we can say CO minus, here OH, here H, like this we said. Okay. Now this CHO, how to write in the sense? Double bond OH. Next step, what in the sense? H minus shift, we have to say. Here this O minus is having three lone pairs. This is shifting here. H minus shifting here, this bond is shifting here. Okay, so like this taking place. So we can say here C double one O OH, Here we can say CH2 O minus, CH2 O minus. Okay, next step, H plus transfer, this bond migrates to this place, acid base neutralization. It is acid, it is base. So we are getting this phenyl ring here, COO minus, it is CH2OH. It is what in the sense CH2OH, you can say. Now, this aldehyde group undergoes oxidation to give carboxylate anion. This aldehyde group undergoes reduction to give alcoholic part. So within the molecule, two groups, one group undergoing reduction, one group undergoing oxidation. Therefore, it is called intramolecular Kanizare reaction, we can say. In this one, which step is rate determining step? Which step is slow step in the sense? This H minus transfer, this hydride shift is called a rate determining step. It is called a slowest step. It is called a slowest step, we can say. Why it is slowest step? Because sigma bond is breaking. Sigma bond has to shift to hydrogen. But in other cases and all, not like that. It is nucleophilic attack. Nucleophilic electrophilic attack. Here acid-base neutralization. But here H has to break the sigma bond completely. H has to take sigma bond towards itself. This electronegativity is low when compared to carbon. Even then, this H is taking this bond completely and attacking this H minus shift. Therefore, it is the slowest step. Therefore, it is a rate determining step. This step we can say slowest step and rate determining step we can say. Okay, sir. So, next, intramolecular Kanizare reaction. Another step we will take. Another reaction we'll see. Here, phenyl ring. It is having one CHO group, one aldehyde group. Here one aldehyde group, another phenyl ring, another phenyl ring. Here one aldehyde group is there. Here one aldehyde group is there. Okay. Now concentrated alkali we'll add. We'll add concentrated alkali. Okay. So two aldehyde groups are there. We are adding concentrated alkali. We are adding. Okay. So, what is the product we will get? We will see. First step is nucleophile has to attack. Nucleophile can attack which carbon? Which aldehyde? All the aldehyde groups are equivalent. Therefore, OH minus can attack any one of the aldehyde. Okay. So, OH minus is attacking any one of the aldehyde we know. Therefore, if OH minus is attacking this one, then we will get like this. This is aldehyde. Then here phenyl ring. Here aldehyde. Here also aldehyde. Okay. Now, in the Kanizare reaction, in the sense, one aldehyde will undergo reduction, another aldehyde undergo oxidation. So, out of these two aldehydes, one aldehyde undergo OH minus is attacked. Similarly, out of these two aldehydes also, one aldehyde can be attacked by OH minus, no? Sir, out of these two, which aldehyde will be attacked by OH minus? Up or down? Which we have to take? This up aldehyde or down aldehyde in the sense? Let us take down, not up. Why? Because already here, up aldehyde is attacked by OH minus. Therefore, here we must take down aldehyde. Why is it so? That also question is there. We will get an answer soon. Now, here we can write O minus CH OH. Here CHO. Here phenyl ring. Here CHO, here OH minus is attacking this one. Okay, OH minus is attacking this carbonyl carbon. Therefore, here O minus OH H.